Reverse quickie. Let's say you have three sports teams, the Blue Devils, the Red Devils, and the Plaid Devils. You set it up where each team plays the other once. The Blue Devils beat the Red Devils beat the Plaid Devils, and the Plaid Devils beat the Blue Devils. So which is the best team? How would you even seed them for the playoffs? You've just run into Condorcet's paradox. The Marquis de Condorcet formalized this in the late 18th century when considering the preferences of voters. Given a voting system where people rank candidates by preference, the victor is the one that gets ranked above the others. But what happens when you run into this paradox? Condorcet's solution was to consider the weight of the victory. If the Blue Devils win by 20 points, but the Red Devils and the Plaid Devils only squeaked by 1 point ahead, those victories are not considered to be the same, so the Blue Devils will be considered the champions. Now, apply this to things like the products you buy or anything you enjoy. How can there possibly be an objective best or worst that a central planner could use to make those decisions? The transitivity of an individual's preferences does not result in a transitivity of societal preferences, and that's the problem with all forms of collectivism. What's the best sport? What's the best fast food restaurant? Who makes the best cars? Collective preferences run into this paradox because people's preferences are subjective. That's why there can never be an expression of collectivized preferences. The only fair way to meet people's preferences is with the free market.